Hello everyone, we are going to talk about limitation of expansion, and we are going to talk about an absolute value of x less than 4 when x is between k, minus k and k. Example, absolute value x minus 4 less than 1. Then x minus 4 between minus 1 and 1. And we move at 4 to our place. To our side, 4 minus 1 is 3, 4 plus 1 is 4, and 4 minus 4 is 0. So x between 3 and 4. And x minus 8 less than k, then x is minus k plus 8 and k plus 8. Now we are going to define the limitation. For each value theta is very, very little, very little value theta, positive value theta, there exists another little value alpha positive, and x is in definition set of function, so that absolute below x minus alpha is greater than 0 and less than alpha. Then absolute below x of x minus b is less than faith. What that suffers to me, what that means, you have a function in one interval. You have a function in one interval. In that interval and that interval. And this is X. For each X, then X goes not A, goes not A. Assume that A is here. When X is there, going A, how in A interval, from right or from left, goes not up. Then F of X in that value. It is here and here. Then this one of is E here. And then F of X goes on B. And when we are going close to A, that the absolute value of X minus A is less than alpha, very little, then this is also little, less than beta. Then it is so. Example, or we can tell that this is x minus 3 is less than beta divided by 4. Then, but we know that x minus 3 is less than beta. Then beta divided by 4 is greater than or equal to alpha. Then we have approved that limit is correct. Another example is over by 2 when x goes on 2 is 4. So we are going to use instead of 3 is 2 and x 2 minus 4. But this one is x minus 2, x plus 2 is less than beta. X plus 2 absolute log. When x goes to 2, we take x with a radiation 1 and 3, because in x axis it is 1, 2, 3, and it takes x 1, and then x plus 2 is 3 and 1. And the maximum value of this one is 5. Then absolute x minus 2 is less than theta divided by 5. Why x minus 2 is less than alpha? Then alpha is less than or equal to theta genome 5. Then we have approved that for each beta, we find alpha less than theta genome 5, which if minus 2 less than alpha, give us the function minus the value of limitation is less than each value of the beta. We are going to have another example, and it is the limit x to minus 2 divided by x minus 2 is equal to 7. When x goes to 6, and we have instead of 8, it's 3 here. Function minus 7. I always think this is the must be less than delta. But this one is x2 minus 2 minus 7 multiplied by x minus 2 divided by x minus 2 absolute below equals to x2 minus 7 x minus 7 minus 2 is 14 minus 2 is 12 divided by x minus 2. But this one is x minus 3 x minus 4. Then x minus 3 multiplied by x minus 4 divided by x minus 2. As you see, we have to find that of here, which is x minus 3 multiplied by x minus 4, x minus 2, absolute below. Value and to have this the maximum value, then this must be max and this must be min to be the denominator max, the denominator min, minimum to make this part max. And for B, x goes to 3. We can again have a value. This is number 3 here. We can have 3.5 or 2.5. We take a ring to so, but you can also have 2 and 4, doesn't matter. So x minus 4, when x minus 4 is 0 and minus 2. So, and this one is 0 and 2 division. So, the minimum value minus 2 divided by this one, this is minus 1, and the maximum value is 0 divided by anything is 0. So that is because we need another, we need another thing. 2, 2.5, 3.5. Then this one is going from the 1.5 minus 1.5 and minus half, and another one is 2 with the half and 1.5. Then the minimum value divided by this is minus 1, and the maximum value divided by this is 3. One unit. then the maximum value of z is 1 divided by 3. This is less than beta, then this 1 divided by 3, then 6 minus 3 absolute is less than beta divided by 3, then alpha less than or equal to beta divided by 3. Means that for each value of beta, we can find the value alpha, then this expression is valid, and we have a proof that it is true. Okay. Now we are going to have another function. Limit of x to minus 3x plus 3 equals to 1. But this expression, we can write it as that minus that multiplied by that plus 1 multiplied by 2. We use the same, it is 1, the total is 1, but it is multiplied. This one multiplied by this one is the x squared of power by 2, it is x2 minus 3x plus 3 minus 1 divided by this one. Then you must make it maximum. You must make it maximum. X goes to 1 in that interval, and we take the ratio 1 from 0 to 2. Then X 0, which is minus 2 divided by 0, 0, plus 1. And then it is 2, it is 0 divided by something. Then it is in that interval. Then the maximum of this value value is 5, the maximum value is 5, and put it here, and it's going to a value like, I don't know, something. The maximum value is 10, we call the whole value D, and it is up to x minus 1 less than beta divided by D, which is known. That means that alpha less than or equal to beta divided by D. Another function is because we will find if this part inside this function, if you are going to make a addition, x4 plus x minus 18 divided by x minus 2, then x3 of x4 minus 2 x3 with minus plus equals 2 x3 plus x minus 18 plus 2 x2, then 2 x3 plus minus 4 is 2. This is minus, this is plus. Then it is 4 is 2 plus x minus 18. Then it is plus 4x. This is 4 is 2 minus 8x. This is plus minus. It is 9x minus 18. Then it is plus 9, which is 9x minus 18. And it is 0 here. And we have this one. Then, after the x minus 2, after the x3 plus 4, 2 is 2. Plus 4 is less than beta. Then we put the value 2 in this. This is 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 9. 24 plus 9 is 35. 24. 33. Then absolute 6 minus 2 less than beta divided by 33, then alpha is less than or equal to theta divided by 33. And if x goes to R8, absolute x minus 8 between 0 and alpha. If y goes to A, then y minus A less than beta. If x goes to plus infinity, then x less than x is greater than a big value n. If x goes to minus infinity, then x less than minus n. The biggest negative value. If y goes to plus infinity, y is greater than n, and y goes to minus infinity, y is less than minus n. And if goes to infinity, y goes to infinity, then x bigger than n, absolute x, and absolute y bigger than n. Divided by x minus 2 probably by 2 is plus infinity when x goes to 2. Then we have for each beta, for each n, because it is plus, for each n, very big value, positive value, there exists a very little positive value, x is in definition, and x minus 2 less than alpha, and this value is 5 divided by divided by x minus 2 is greater than n. But we can exchange x minus 2 over by 2 divided by 5 is going to change the direction less than 1 divided by n. Then x minus 2 over by 2 is less than y divided by n. Then absolute value of this is less than square root of 5 divided by n, which is this one. Then alpha less than or equal to 5 divided by 10. Now we have another. We have 6 minus 1. And we have the same here. And then we change the x minus 1 to here and make this mean the denominator must be minimum, make this one maximum. The denominator from 1 and 3, then x is 0 or 2, then the maximum is 2, and this one is going to be 2, and this one is going to be 2, and later 2. You can take also 1.5, 2.5, and from the function, but the simplest is that. Okay. Now we are going to have another minus 4, minus, and then x goes to 1. We are going to have a for each for each value, if it's value n, there is an alpha, little positive value alpha, then absolute x minus 1 is less than alpha, then this expression minus 4 divided by this is bigger than or is less than minus n. We must tell both sides is minus 1 going to be divided by x minus 2 divided by 2. We get n, because it changed its direction. We are going to n squared, and alpha is going to be less than or equal to 2 divided by n squared. Now we are going to have another function. Value beta is a very big value m. X is definition and x, then absolute x bigger than m, and the function divided by beta means that absolute x is less than one divided by beta squared. Then we have finally then n is bigger than or equal to 1 divided by 12. Okay. For each big value, big positive value n, there exists big positive value n when x is in this definition, and so down that absolute x greater than n when we can add